All right. Can you all hear me? In the back? Okay. Well, we're going to get started. I'm sure many people in the true tradition of Cornell will rifle in a few minutes late and just make themselves comfortable. So, hello, I'm Laura Cabrera. It is my absolute pleasure to welcome you to the second Systems Thinking Symposium here at Cornell University. We have been preparing this for a long time and are excited to see you all here. I am very happy to see familiar faces and also a lot of new faces in the audience. I have to also welcome our equally important online audience who happen to be from all over the globe. We have over 600, but since this slide was made, now 700 attendees total from more than 31 states in the United States and 39 countries, including Poland, India, Ecuador, Scotland, Uruguay, China, and all of these people have come together today to hear 22 speakers. One of us is sick, I'm sorry for that, from a broad range of disciplines and areas, and we're all going to talk about one single and important topic, which is systems thinking. So we're excited to bring that to you. So before we begin the program, I want to give you a couple of logistics. One, please silence your cell phones so we don't distract our speakers. Each speaker only has 10 minutes. So we have built time in just before lunch for you to have questions for the morning speakers. And we have time just before the reception for you to have questions for the afternoon speakers. So jot down your thoughts and save them for those times. And please do keep track of if you want to ask them, because we can have some rich discussion. We've also built in some breaks. We've built in time for you to have lunch on your own. We have a lovely reception at the end of the day, and I'm hoping you all will stay and have great conversations between and among us about the topics that we're talking about. And I'm sure many of you have mutual interests that you haven't yet discovered. So I encourage you to stay for that as well. Let's see. We have all of the bios of the speakers up on our website, cornellsysthink.com. I encourage you to read those. I am not going to bore you as I introduce speaker after speaker with their long, impressive bios. They all have one, so please take your time to read those as well. I have to take a particular moment right now to thank our two primary sponsors. The first is USDA's Think Water Initiative, which is led by our good friend, Dr. Jennifer Kushner in the back from the University of Wisconsin, and also Cornell's Institute for Public Affairs, directed by Dr. Sharon Tennyson here in the front. I would like to tell you that both Jen and Sharon are highly committed to the idea that education is a powerful agent of change, and I want to really just take a minute to thank them from all of our hearts for their support and efforts to make this event come to fruition. So just a second of applause for you guys. So thank you. And I have to mention also, we are highly supported by a bunch of other and a wide range of impressive sponsors. So I want to make sure that you recognize them as well. Some people are here from each of these organizations today. So we need to make sure, and also online, I'm sure. So I'm excited. We have a really unique symposium for you today. We have some introductory sort of keynote remarks about systems thinking and the state of the field. We'll then switch to 10-minute TED-style talks by an impressive array of professionals and students. They'll each convey their application of systems thinking to their areas of interest. They'll have just enough time to explain their work and talk about how they've applied systems thinking, so do try to track them down at lunch and breaks to talk more deeply if you need to. I told you their bios are online. You should read those. They're really impressive. The other thing I would really want to note is, while all of these speakers come from a wide array of institutions, they will all apply the same four underlying rules of systems thinking to the complex problems that they're working on every day. So, for example, you'll hear about West Point's work with the Army Corps of Engineers. You'll hear about the California drought. You'll hear about meeting the needs of underserved populations in Mexico and the role of water in odor perception. So that's a pretty wide range just in a short list. While we do focus today mostly on policy and water-related issues, I hope you leave today excited to apply these rules and systems thinking to your own area of interest and your own work. Policy and water issues are the focus of today's presenters from two cohorts of fellows. New to systems thinking, all of these fellows have had brief instruction in these underlying rules and been asked to apply them to their own areas of research. And I will tell you, they've done excellent work in a very short amount of time. You will be impressed by them all. Both groups of the fellows are part of ongoing research to determine the optimal way to teach systems thinking to different groups of people. And after all, if all of us, regardless of our discipline, our preferred methodologies, or the substantive topic that we're interested in, if we are unable to apply systems thinking to our work, it really is of limited utility. So finally, I will be your MC throughout the day. I will highlight important connections between and among the speakers as you hear them, and emphasize the utility of systems thinking generally.